parce qu'il y a une guerre qui nous forme. Parce que quand vous voyez l'autre, on dit, il y a son fils. Bien de ça. Il dit, donc son fils, il donne parce qu'il y a un peu de fils. Allô? Il est dans le doigt. Il y a quelque chose qui est dans la terre. When I said that you need to be spiritually patient, but even God asks people, is God patient? If everybody is not patient, what will the Bible do with patient? God does not treat everybody equally. Don't deceive yourself. Hello? I can show you from Genesis to Revelation that God is patient. Even though God, we have been taught that God is not patient, but this is what God said. On the next man will I meet. The man who is humble and of a contrite heart, but what? Takes my bowl at my word. We know that when we call two people before God, before God, we consider to complete one of you on first. That's what the specific is going to consider. Which one of you, my order, which one of you is humble? Which one of you is friendly to your word? God will consider the man that honors him or her before considering the man who does not honor you. Let me say something. The older man will give you another soul because they are watching you from two natural and the time of my man. Let them know because you may be also international. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And say about his pleasure, pleasure of God, not of Christ.
Yes.
But if you do what you want to do, you have to judge according to what you have done.
That is it.
So if it's better to you, it's why you are developing.
No, the partiality is a man. The partiality now is that a man. That's what he said. You have done what God wants you to do. Somebody has not done what God wants you to do. He's not coming to God. Between you who is doing what God asks you to do and the person who is not doing what God asks you to do, who is the one who answers it?
It's not about his study.
I understand what you're saying. You see that picture that I will be merciful and you won't be merciful. It's a different body, and you see, most of the time they have quoted scriptures, and most of the time they have quoted them at the context. When Paul was talking about how the merciful and the woman were merciful, he was actually talking in terms of the context of the Israelites, and he was talking in context of Jacob and Esau. God decided that God was over Jacob above Esau. I am God, thank you, for the suffering at the goal. That one, nobody can pray in. That is the severity of God. God can choose to show mercy to a non believer, to make you mercy to a non believer. But when it comes to God of His word, born again, who knows the truth? Who are dwelling on the word of God? God says in His word, unto this man will I look. First, if I'm going to consider anybody's first, let me show you that scripture. Isaiah 62. So I'm going to pass it to you what you're saying. Isaiah 16. It is 66. God says in His word, if I'm going to consider anybody first, this is the person I am going to consider before I consider any other person. Hallelujah. I rise up to 66, verse 1 and 2. And I want to show you another scripture. Okay. God said the Lord, the heaven is my throne, and the earth is my what? My footstool. Where is the earth that you build unto me? And where is the place of man? Verse 2. For all those things, God is trying to tell us now, all those things in the family of the angel, for all those things at my end were me, and all those things can be, said the Lord. But I want to take the point. But to this man, let what? Even to him that what? Poor and of a contrite spirit, and trembled at my word. And Paul is saying, I'm going to consider anybody first. I'm going to consider the person who won me. Just like what you have said to me. It is a principle of God. What you do to me, he must consider you because somebody does not do the will of God. The act of mercy is a different thing. It's a different body completely, but one for those of us who are in the house of God, and what God said from them. Paul was talking to Timothy. He said, if you want to do good, now look at this picture. Paul said, do good unto how many people? All men. Let's read that scripture so that we don't see that for you at one. Paul said, do good unto all men, but he put a box there. He said, but especially to the household of faith in the a non-believer, and another person is a believer, who is the, whether it's a member of your church or a member of your church, you are working together. A non-believer who is not an actual member of the same, as Jesus did. A believer who is born again, as Jesus did. God said, do good to all of them. But if you have to do good, consider first the believer before the different religion. You understand? This is the benefit that we have as a believer that God will do good unto us first before he will do unto other people. Now, I told you last week that the Pharisees came to Jesus and they told him to Jesus that a man who was a Gentile, his son was sick. Let's read that scripture, Luke chapter 7. Let's read Luke chapter 7 before we go to consider our name. Luke chapter 7, I will show you this is one of the reasons why I tell you that God is partial. He's partial, and I'm partial at the time that God will favor one believer above another. But God is saying, in terms of partiality that I mean is this, God is going to consider the people who love him first, the people who serve him first, the people who obey him first. When God compares to the parents, most of us who are parents, when our children do not have the parents most, and do things that we serve. When you go to the market, that is the first person you want to do the dance with. Is that not true? Every other person is a rebound of the only time that I see your children. But this one, he pisses me. And mommy, mommy is not good, or you are being pastor. I am not being pastor, but even though it's not the room, you know, because this one pisses you. Luke chapter 7, let's read Luke chapter 7 from verse 9. And here you see the story. Now, when he had ended all the saying in the audience of the people, he entered into other man. Continue. And a certain centurion, don't forget that the centurion at that time was a Roman soldier, was a Gentile. He was not part of the commonwealth of Israel. The blessing of Israel does not belong to him. The miracles of Jesus does not belong to them. Remember that even when Jesus came, he told his disciples, when they were sending them out 2 by 2, he said, I am sending you out. Don't go to the Gentile. Go to the lost sheep of Israel. Even if a Gentile need miracle signs and wonder, don't give it to them. Go and give it first. To you, and to the Jew. He said, so the salvation, Paul also said that in Romans chapter 11, he said, salvation is first of the Jew before you and me. Hello? And I told you, and you are better. God is better than. Because anybody is going to just say first, the Jews first, then the Gentiles second. So, what more to say? That God is partial? Yes, that is the sovereignty. That is the way God chose the one to do that. Salvation belongs to the Jews first, before you and I. Because after the Jew refuses the salvation and they refuse the gospel, then the gospel goes to you and I. And that is why in Romans chapter 11, Paul was saying that their rejection of the gospel has led to rejection for you and me. So we should find out that the Jews actually rejected the gospel. If they did not receive the gospel, maybe the gospel will not come to you and I. All of us will be going straight elsewhere. But thank God because their rejection of the gospel has brought salvation to the Gentiles. Back in Luke chapter 7, verse 2. And a certain centurion servant who was dear unto him was sick and ready to die. Verse 3 continue. And when he heard of Jesus, he sent unto him the elders of the Jews, beseeching him that he will come and heal his servant. Verse 4. And when they came to Jesus, they besought him instantly, saying that he was worthy for whom he should do this. Verse 5. And Jesus said, why should I do it? And he said to Jesus, for he loveth our nation, and he has built us a wall. When Jesus heard that he had built his synagogue, what happened? The next verse. Then Jesus did what? He didn't want to go before. Jesus didn't want to go. The word you have is a danger. The gospel is not for him. He said, but when Jesus heard that, then Jesus did what? Went with them. And when he was now far from there, the centurion came to him saying, saying unto him, Lord, trouble not thyself. This is a man of faith. He said, for I am not worthy that thou shouldest enter my room. Verse 7. Wherefore, neither thought I myself worthy to even come unto thee, but say to the Lord, and my servant shall be what? Shall be here. And Jesus made a comment about this man. For the man said, for I also am a man set under authority, even under my soldiers. And I said to one, go and do it. And to another, go and do it. And to my servant, do this and do it. No pain. Go back to us. Go back to us. I don't want to see spiritual authority and leadership here. This is the gentleman who was saying to Jesus, when I said to people, go out to the door, come back to the corner, do this, they do it. What's the good thing in English? Nobody asks, where should I do it? Or what should I do it? I know. Now, everywhere you see people who go behind authority, negative flows, you see? Love, joy, there's people. Give me that, verse 9. Verse 9 now. After the verse 7, look at what Jesus said. When Jesus heard this thing, he marveled at him and turned him about and said unto the people that followed him, I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, not even in Israel. But in the Bible, and the people that were sent, returning to the house, found the servant all that had been sick. People, Jesus had come to the ministry, the first of the books. God had given the man said, Jesus, I believe you. Whatever you say will come to pass. Act of the same. Every word you hear in this house, every prayer that pastor prays for you, every release of the word of God in this house, from everybody that is standing here, pastor, your knees believing, may it come to pass in your life in Jesus' name. So the fact that you are going to see a manifestation, you must believe that God is and is the reward of who? Of those who do what? You can, some people cannot be diligently seeking God and you expect the same result. You by serving him after serving, or even with and serving him after serving, after God expect the same result. That's why I think that God is a just God. And if favor does not favor his cause, you favor me, I favor you. Hello? It is when you read the Bible, you hear from someone, you wonder, is it right? A musician in Nigeria said, do me a duty, don't know the rest. Show me a show to you. God, is that exactly the one that was reading the book of 1 Samuel? When God was ready, when God was ready to deal with Eli, God said unto Eli, he said, he that honor me, I will honor. He that despise me, can do what? What is it going to do? Show me a duty. Do you know that that is what is the same thing? God said, honor me, I will honor you. Despise me, I will despise you. You understand what I'm saying? That is the pattern of God. When we honor him, he will honor us back. When we love him, he will love us back. When we trust him, when we sacrifice our time, go to Acts of the Apostles chapter 10. So today we are talking about remembrance. And I want to show you that every time you come to the Acts of God, and you give your time, your body, your money, your tears, cleaning the hands, you are sowing the seed. What are you doing? Please, let your mindset be changed to mind. When you talk about seed, think beyond money. Money is part of seed sowing, but it is not the only way of sowing seed. Let me say that again. Money is part of seed sowing, but it is not the only way of seed sowing, or sowing seed. Let me show you something. The Acts of the Apostles chapter 10, there was a story of Cornelius, a man who happened to be a Gentile. Acts of the Apostles chapter 10, from verse 9 to verse 4. And I will read to verse 10. To verse 10, we are going to verse 8. There was a certain man in Sicily called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian band. And let me tell you something, when the Bible becomes a centurion of the Italian band, it means that this man has nothing less than 80 soldiers and 100 soldiers under him. It was like a big boss. A man who has a lot of people that he controls. Go back to verse, the next one. And the Bible said, this man, I want you to look at something here. This man was a Gentile and was a devout man. And one that he was with all And what does he do? He gives much alms to the people and prays to God. How many times? He was serving God the way he knew, but he was doing righteous, he was doing consistent, he was sacrificing. He was giving time, he was praying, and his members were just investing. And he saw in a vision, evidently, this is one of the reasons we believe in vision. In days, he was only that we don't believe in vision, we believe in vision, we believe in dreams, we believe in revelation. So that's why people God does not speak to you that dream, that vision, that revelation, you are a great man. And what, but we also believe that the greatest word of prophecy is the word of God. The Bible calls the scripture the sure, the most sure word of prophecy. This is the most sure word of prophecy. Let's go on. I said, this is sure. In a vision, heavenly about the ninth hour of the day, an angel of God coming into him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, what is it? Yeah. And he said unto him, thy prayers, everybody in that place, you have to go. Thy prayers and thy hands are covered for what? What do you call the memorial? Remembrance. Your prayers. Many of you are praying now, and it looks as if God is not answering your prayer. But let me tell you something. If you are praying and you think that your prayer is not being answered, I want you to know that what you are doing is prayer only. I know you don't know what I'm doing. Let me have a look. If you don't make a deposit, you can't make a withdrawal. So if God is not asking you now, don't stop praying, keep on praying, you are thanking your prayer. One day, but you are being remembered. One day, your prayers are come to a memorial. Some of you say, I've given you this, I've not done this, I've not gotten anything. No, sir. The angel said unto Cornelius, your prayers and your hands, your tithes, your offering, your special seed, your coming to church is a seed, is a sacrifice, and you are showing one day everyone is going to come to remember. That is going to be an answer at the time you don't expect. Don't stop praying, don't stop giving help, don't stop coming to church. Every time you come to church, it's a seed, don't be tired. What the devil wanted to do is for you to be tired and stop showing seed. He wanted to stop sacrificing. He put the mountain in fire all day and time with the Christianity. We come to church, Holy Ghost, nothing, no sin. The truth is that you are banking your, the banking certain things in the heavenly realms. But when the heaven will break the news over your bed, there will be so much blessing that even yourself will be wanting to hear. This God, I have not pray. No, sir, it's not that you have not prayed. You pray, your prayer will be deficit. Your prayers, your prayers are in fixed deposits. And you are going to start having, some of you will be having withdrawals and release in 3 months. Some people in the next 6 months. Some people in the next 1 year. Second God will break open for you. You know, it's a thing that people say to people. Stop saying they are asking us for money in the church always. Where are we going to ask you for money if it's not in the church? If they're not asking for money in the mosque, are they going to the mosque and ask for money? I don't even know if they're praying in the mosque. And I have that. That's all I know to do. If I open the money, you have me. But God has found the church. The church is a ground. It's like a farmland. Where we go to plant seed. Every day, and we keep on watering the seed, watering the seed of our time, of our money, of our body, and we keep on watering it with prayers. And you know how that the Bible says in the book of Psalm 122, for them that God are weeping, bearing precious seed in their hand, so likewise with all, and that is the greatest. Now look at what the angel said unto Cornelius quickly. Verse 4, that's the kind of person that does. Then, in verse 4, the angel says something back to the person that does. He said, I need to look up in the street and he said, what is it here? And he said, I'm going to do prayers. And I what? Everybody, and I what? I come up for what? A memorial before God. Verse 5. And now, send men to Joppa and call for one Simon, whose surname is what? Verse 6. in London with one Simon the Farmer, whose house is by the seaside, is accomplishing what God purposed to do. Verse 7. And when the angel with the name of the Cornelius was depicted, he told you of his household servant, and he begins to gather them together on him continually. Verse 8. And when he had declared all his sin unto God, he sent them to where? To Joppa. And let me see something to you. Why is it that the angel did not preach the message to Cornelius? Hello? The angel could have preached to Cornelius, but let me say this. God will not duplicate certain things that I have given to you to other people to preach for you. That certain solution that God has put in the hand of your pastor, certain solution in the hand of your husband, certain solution is in the hand of your wife, certain solution is in the hand of your pillow. God is not going to show some of you. You'll be praying, praying, God, show me, God, say, I have shown you, what are you doing with what I've shown you? God will tell you, listen to the word you are hearing of God. God will not repeat it, but the angel will preach to continue to refuse to preach to you. He said, what is time for coming? He will tell you what to do. But you can have faith in God and you are not going to waste time. Because some things you are not too sure. It's in the hand of some men. You are not too sure about it now. I said, some things you are not too sure. It's in the hand of some men. The breakthrough you are not too sure is in the hand of somebody. The connection you are not too sure is in the hand of somebody. God, you need to know where is my Simon or which need to be. Because when you see your Simon, he will show you what to do and that will come through. I can't hear you now. God always remembers everything that we do. Coming to church is a sacrifice of sin. God will remember. Your tithe, your offering, everything you do is a sin. And you can use it to challenge God. Remember the story of the Hezekiah. The Lord said unto Isaiah, go and tell Hezekiah, I'm telling you that he will die. He said, put your house in order. I am going to give you to and Hezekiah said to him, immediately Isaiah told him, the king brought with him, the man just went straight to where he went into the house of the Lord. And what did he do? He said, he turned his face to the Lord and he said unto God, Lord, remember how I have sent you. Remember my sacrifice. God, remember that I have done good in this place. Remember that I am not following the system of what I do. So, Lord, I don't want to die now. You can't tell me God. But we think you have not been sowing seed. You have not been coming to the house of God every day. You have not been battering the ground, sowing seed, preaching, evangelizing. All these things are sacrificing and seeing. You have not been showing kindness to your brother, your sister, you see in the church. Every time they see you, your face is too hard. You want to show the seed of small last time is difficult for you. Your face is like you don't see it. Because I don't know. You will squeeze your face. Even when people come to talk, when they meet you, you want to run back. What is your problem? Learn to smile. People smiling is the seed. Show kindness. That is how we used to say that. Mary McKee in this way. When you see a brother standing by the road, just stop and say, he go the long way. And when you see a brother walking down along the way, with a heavy load, along the sea road, you gotta show a little kindness, show a little kindness. Is that what you're doing about that? Oh, thank you, you're part of the issue. Shine the light for everyone to see. I got a shy little kindness. Thank you. Narrow minded. That is something for everybody. Amen. Let the soul seed of kindness. People come to church for the first time. Can notice some people that make it. Even the choir, they are singing. What is on YouTube? Is that what? Some people sitting by them could never stand up to shake hands. What is your problem? Let the show kindness be having discussed. Help them. Show them. Let's show them we love them. This is Jesus Christ. Get up from your seat. You can give a hand. Some people have not seen handshakes in their contact with someone. Some people have not even seen or be the first person to give them that hope. one day God is going to call you to remember it. When we call the seventh time, we start in that seven. And we are here. And there is nobody to sing to as he's singing to the empty chair. God is going to remember our faithfulness to sing to the empty chair. And God will also remember your own commitment. And when you are in the room, you say, so everybody, you say, seed. You say, what? Everything in life is seed. Seed sowing is not money. Your behavior is a seed, your laughter is a seed, your kindness is a seed, your prayer is a seed, your plea to church is a seed, your helping somebody is a seed. Amen. Proverbs chapter 9, quickly. First Samuel chapter 9, verse 1. Some of the powerful testimonies are known as late time at the new world, they say, I become active, there is many testimony along the way. Second, First Samuel, the first Samuel chapter 9, verse 1. Free. Amen. Amen. Let's read. Now there was a man of Benjamin whose name was. Oh, sorry, I'm going to say 1 Samuel 15. Sorry. 1 Samuel 15, not 1. 1 Samuel 15. 15 from verse 1. 1 Samuel 15 from verse 1. And although it was me, I want to try to show that God always remembers. In my 15 years, 20 years, God will remember. People who do you with that God is going to remember and is going to get there. Remember us is a very powerful teaching. So that is why we are going to be conscious of the things you are doing against other people. Because whatever you do against other people, you are also going to see. When you see seed of people and wickedness, God is also going to remember. So if you are showing any wickedness seed, you are doing it. Put the seed on it and let it die. Let it die now. Don't see it. So Lord, I'm sorry, all these things I've been saying, all these bad things, Lord, I repent. Never you plant seed of evil for your children. Don't leave wickedness to your children. Because whatever seed you sow now, if you don't repeat your seed, I'm going to repeat. So don't plant any wickedness seed. Because me, I want to do good life for my children. I want them better life than me. Yet I have struggled more than to struggle. Your children should not go through what you've been through. They should not. What is that? Some of you, when you are back home in Africa, when you are going to school, nobody was speaking with parents. But now you take your children to school with parents. It's almost a good life for them. So when you are going to start your own life, what do you think are going to be using to take your children? Then you take class. You know what I'm saying? You can see. Your parents went through some things so that you can have the one you have now. So when you are going through some things that your children are not going to be better off. Just because this is a law of spirituality. Hello? What do I say? It's a law, it's a spiritual law. You need to understand the word of God. Everything we do, God is keeping record. What Psalm chapter 15 verse 1? Samuel also said, let that be the man to go. Samuel also said unto Saul, the Lord sent me to anoint you to be what? King over his people, over Israel. Now, dear Saul, hearken thou unto the voice of the word of the Lord. Verse 2. Thou seest the Lord of hosts. What? And do what? That which Amalek did for who? And they did what? In the way when you take up of. Verse 2. Now, I want to bring judgment. I remember what they did to you. Now, I want to do them. Now, go and do all. Smite Amalek. And utterly destroy all that they have. And spare them not. But slay both man and woman. Infant and suckling. Ox and sheep. Camel and ass. If you need to go back and read the ceremony for you to understand what Amalek did. When Israel was coming out of Egypt, they wanted to pass through the land of the Amalekites. And they told the Amalekites, we will not go through your city, just let us go by the time. We will pay money for the water we will drink. Anything we buy from you, we will pay. Just let us pass through. And the Bible said, Amalek refused them to pass through their land. Not only that, but also they went and they attacked Israel. And kill the feeble ones among them, because they are not strong. Kill their young ones, and they did not save them. Years and years and years and years. This by theologian for over 350 years now, God is saying, I remember what he did to you. Remember it to my danger. Hello? Tell your neighbor, God remembers. Don't think that God does not remember. God remembers every second that you are making mistakes. Your prayers is coming to God as a memorial. There is a remembrance of what you have done. Your prayers, don't think that God does not see. Ask for what you say, have you prayed and prayed? Yes. There is a remembrance coming for you. And I hear someone say amen. So that's when we talk about signs of God's forbear. And we saw that number 14. I said, don't you forbear to be easily divert your secret and take away your sheep popularity for themselves. They will tear you down. They build their own reputation as good and as bad. Never be like the people who forget. Remember all the good things God has done for you. Remember your parents. Remember the whole sacrifice for you. Remember the whole labor for you. Remember your person. Because God will always remember. Hello? Because God will always do what? God will always do what? God will always do what? I'll show you how God remembers what Amalek did in Israel. Number 15. Let your number 15. Number 15. God's will forget. This is one of the signs of people who don't forget. God's will forget. Has no conscience. They have no empathy, sympathy, or conscience. People who forget. When you see the way they speak, you will not have to speak with the word of conscience. Never be a people who forget. Psalm 102 says, bless the Lord of my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul, and forget not all the what? All his benefits. Number 16, those who forget seek only their own personal advertisement. It is about them to prepare me, myself, and mine. All people, you see, people who forget, they don't care about other people. Everything has to be just to be one of them. Everything has to be myself and mine. They used to have a saying in our local dialect. People who forget, they have an attitude called, once I wake up, even if anybody else has, let them know that it's not my concern. So that's the key, come on, but then you need to not be a changing. As long as me and my mate are my children. Men who forget and want to be better. You know, so what people who forget, they don't listen to other people's interests, they don't look at other people's benefits. It is about them and them. It is not the spirit of Christ. It is not the life of Christ. Amen. Number 17. Those who forget will be easy for good. Proverbs chapter 17, verse 13. When I saw this picture, it makes me to be ashamed. Don't forget what we are saying tonight. Remember and forget not. Everything you do is a what? Everything you do is a what? I want you to say that if you know what you mean, everything you do is a what? Even me that I'm talking, whatsoever I'm doing now is a seed. And it's always another story. There are some seeds, there are some apples that will never come out of you. One of them is that when I was serving, I protected my boss. I kept him. Everything that I need to do as a good servant, even when people want me to say when he has done something that is bad, and people want me to use him as a good example or a bad example, I refused. So I have said to myself, it's a sin. Let me and now become a leader and sitting on top of my own conglomerates. But people who are working for me will never use me as a bad example of a bad example. Because I've never seen that seed. You understand what I'm saying? I have protected him and done my own to be also protected. So because of this thing, even in your marriage, your relationship, things you are putting in the presence of your children in this seed. When I was growing up, I've never saw my father help my mother's hand. I have never seen them up themselves. I don't know when they kiss. The only thing I see is baby. When you have to, you don't know. drugs, so what they say, I don't know. The only thing I have seen them do in the open, they fight in the open. So when I don't want you, what you do? Because you see, the men are the what the God began to bring into me. I said it to somebody, before I got married, I never read the book of the marriage. I never attended marriage for you. You are blessed in this house, but as the Lord is coming, it's something God wants for you. He's going to save you from some things so that you will not happen to you. Do not exaggerate it. You are not sorry for this happening. When I got married, I believe I'm a spiritual man. My wife is a spiritual woman, spiritual people. Do we understand what I said? Because we speak by the Spirit that has to go to heaven. She knew that I want to be there when I see you. But I thought I'd bring for that. It is not in my God at all. When you step up to me, that one can be answered on the way that you continue like this. I mean, and I said to myself, what shall I do, sir? The dead man is a sister, my first couple. I ran to a bookshop at Konikani. Those of you who know me can remember, like you say, I ran to the bookshop. And after my first marriage book, I got the less and less about saving the marriage before I start all the country of the book. I came back to the night, we are having issue. I pretended I said I was sick. I went to the sitting room and I got reading the book. And the master said, everything the man was saying was talking to me. Everything was saying in the book was me. The man said, when you marry somebody, he said you marry an image. Many of us who have impression, we have created the woman who want the marriage, the man who wants to carry them, beautiful woman, nice woman. So the man who went on to marriage, he discovered the real person. The woman who read the book, the man started saying something. He said something that many of us, the way we are behaving to them in our marriage is the way we are seeing our parents behave when we are married. So you are actually a product of your father. You are a product of your mother. The only thing you can do to become a better person is when you come to the right of God. The word of God is the only thing that has the capacity to change you to the right person. Many of the things we believe about marriage and online, they are contrary to the word of God. And the support said, my little children, of whom I travail unto Christ before you. Everything we do as a believer must reflect the image of Christ. And there is only one person we can choose in the house of God. That is why there is power and there is blessing and everything. The church is an educational and transformational center. So when I read Dr. Lester's report, he said he grew up in seven and his wife, the report and the pastor was what he grew up seeing his teacher holding his mother. Standing on the platform, sipping tea together. And they will look, they will watch TV together, smile at each other. As if the father and the mother, they never go to bed. Even after the serious divorce, the father and the mother will keep them bed. As if they never seen anything to do that. Okay? The man I read was not to be done with him. When I first came married, he took for the internet, that time. He didn't even want to be done with him to work. It was not to be done. So what you do is walk your own and walk your own. You think why does he want me? Why do you want to walk me? Why do you want me? Say your own that's still home. I never saw my father help my mother. I thought I read that book. People know that I've got to my wife so much. Now I read the book, I want to change. There's a change in my mentality. So I'm not going, I want to walk and say, leave me, walk your own and walk my own. That's how I say, I will do that first. So I'm sick. And what I have to walk in. And the thing is not easy to transform yourself. It is only the word of God, and if you are not in a good church where you hear the word of God, you will continue that behavior and you will think it is a good one. It is not. Just see, don't let your children see you quarreling all the time. Because when they see you quarreling all the time, they are young. They are going to also grow up have a mentality of quarreling in your relationship. So that I read that book, I started changing it. I'm not going to let them change that one. So don't, if you are looking for two-star microwave change, is a lie, I don't guarantee that. But the word of God asks you to transform you from one level of glory to another level of growth, to another level of growth, and you become a perfect man in Christ. So how can we, now, I can hold my life, I can walk, I can talk, but it was not easy. But I think I was lazy for him. When I was growing up, I don't like wearing and food. You know what they come and do? I don't like it. When I got back to my coach for his credit, I don't like it. When I got married, when he invited us for wedding, my brother said, let us get this meeting. I don't like to have a meeting. Wear your own, I need to wear a shirt and cover. It's a shirt and cover, I need to wear. I don't like that too. I said, what is it? I don't know how to get up and do that. I'm your husband. You don't need to simple about it. I'm saying, oh, this is... I am not alone. Thank you. So my dear friends, you know, a lot of people are thinking that because every time we hear it, for someone we get married, seminars, married teaching, or something, oh, on the right hand side, it's because we need to put in one of the things. I called my wife, I said, oh, I'm going to love you. And I said, this is all my life. This is all my life. Even you are telling me I love you. This is because we are very far away. I said, no. I said, let me teach you what you need to do. And I have changed completely. I have totally changed. I said, for me, be very happy that you are married to a man you don't know. Because the word of God has a place in me. The word of God has a place in me. I'm not saying, I'm not telling you. He said that the word is working in me. I tell you, I mean, the question is, when you hear the truth, don't see what you want to go back and to the other. The only sense of the word of God is not for you to hear. Not being an hearer alone, not being a speaker alone, but a doer of this work. It's not just for us to come here, we laugh, we enjoy ourselves. No, no, no. What you are hearing, are you applying it? Christianity is proper application of the word of God. What makes a difference when you apply the word? It's not just hearing and speaking it. Practical application. How many of you remember those days in Nigeria and the days of time when we were in Christian Christians? We see. You don't wear hands on TV. Many of you are living in the air. I remember practical Christianity. It's the applied. Amen. Proverbs chapter 17, verse 13. We read that scripture and then I begin to wind up with it. Everyone, let's read this. One to go. Whoso rewarded evil for good. This is our. Who wrote it? Who wrote it? Is it the word of Pastor Yemi? The word of Pastor Bayo? Your father's word? This is the word of God. Whosoever rewarded evil for good, evil shall not depart from what? From your hands. It's a seed. Tell your neighbor, be careful. If you are not saying it, look at your neighbor and say, be careful. No, look at him and say, hey, brother, be careful. Say it to me, say it to me. Say, be careful. Say, Pastor, be careful. Don't show any kind of evil seed. I'm telling you, I am saying this, so this is the word of God. I do not talk when it comes to silence. I'm afraid. Look at your neighbor and say, hey, be careful. Don't show any kind of evil seed. Amen. We need to be afraid when things are this true. If you ever show up, we wanted people for good. People shall not depart from the house. Make up your shadow. We are your shadow. I shook my head with all the keys to my friend and my father. Cover my teacher for self. I told him, you're not to me and then my mother. I want to put your hand as a my father. Any evil seed, any evil thing that I saw. Cautiously or cautiously, I approach them to that. Everything that you are saying, you want that I show. There is what I said I'm not supposed to say. You are forgiveness. I approach them to that. Let them not stay in the house. Let them have no place in the family. Appeal to the evil seed. In the name of Jesus. Number 18. This will forget and will seek revenge to scandalize us. Number 19, those who forget repeat history. Do you know what people understand the problem? When people refuse to have to defend the word of God in them, they will repeat it. In Daniel chapter 5, we watch that scripture, there was a story of Belshazzar, the son of King Nebuchadnezzar. The Bible said that he has forgotten how God dealt with his father. His father stood up one day and said, I should not my hand build this great kingdom, and God called him to marry me. I was speaking to the former years. How many years? Nebuchadnezzar kept class for 100 years. It's about to be. I want to let them talk. How many years? I'm looking at some people. How many years? And you don't know that I'm looking at them. I don't want to call their name. This is about to study. 7 years for the people that went to class. And then he died. His son came to be killed by his sister. The Bible says, and he took out the golden vessel that they brought from Jerusalem. And you are using it, you are having acting with this, you are having a battle with this people. And you started using the golden vessel to come to life. And suddenly the angel of God came on the hand and care of the world and in groups. Many people of the city. Nobody can read it. He called down there. And then he said, open this thing is unto you. He said, you should have known what God did to your heart because you refused to remember. He said, you should refuse to remember. Don't fear the Lord. You have been put in the balances. You have been weighed and you have found wanting. He said, and tonight the kingdom shall be taken away from thee because of what you will do that will provoke God to remove glory and honor from you. You will believe in Jesus. God became angry and said unto God, Father, tonight I will take the pain from you. I will give it to the madness and the passion who are better than you. And you know something? Even in the midst of the things we said to them that we should promote by now, what will happen that will make you to promote you in your office will happen in Jesus' name. And it promotes Daniel that we do. And in the night, the media came. The media, and the king, and the king was there. And the king was there. Now, because they repeated the stupid error of his father, they repeated it. Now, I say this, I found that. Please have it in the name of Jesus. Some of you, you have had your parents using words when you are praying. And you find certain situations trying to happen or the about to happen or is happening in your life or similar to what happened to your parents. And remember your mother made an altar and said, Father made an altar. Now you find yourself in the same situation. You don't need prayer and fasting to know what to do. I tell you what to do. Every time you find a repeat of history, act contrary to history. What do I do? Don't say the same thing that your mother said to your father that provoked them. Don't say the same thing that your father said to your mother that provoked them. Don't stick to quiet and need to talk. Because it is one of the spiritual way of winning, learning to be quiet things. May the Lord help you. And the last thing there in that note is that husband and wife. Couples, verse number 21, couples who forget easily what they are doing in one outside. On the pages of newspaper in Babylon, if you want to go, and don't press your partner. It creates more than bitterness than you do the couple in. Don't let us believe that all these iniquities are not. When they are living themselves, that is when they know that the man is not what is right. That's when they know that the man is not. This is good at this day. No. We don't believe like that as stable. Remember and forget not. Everything you do is a law, is a sin. One day, that will be remembered. One day, that will be a law. Put your hands on that day. Sister Rose, I want to come and give you a testimony. Let's hear us, Sister Rose, give you a testimony. Hallelujah. But let me pray for you, Sister Rose, for me. I want to pray to praise your wife. I want to pray your soul and family, my father and my God. From today, the promise, the soul good seed, in words, in character, in deed, in coming to the hands of God, in prayer, in giving my body, in giving my time, in giving my substance, Lord, from today, I soul good seed. Every day of my life, let it come back to me in 100-fold, 30-fold, and 60-fold in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Bless this God, Lord. Bless your mind, Father. Bless the people in Jesus' mighty name of God. Amen. Put your hand up, Sister Rosemary, as you give us that testimony.
Just so you know how I
having your muscle, you know, it's like, well, what kind of muscle is that? You know, it happens every single day. You know, and then after weeks and months of complaining, she said, okay, let's get an ultrasound. So, you know, I went for an ultrasound, got an ultrasound, got the body back and said, you know, we have the result coming, you know. So I started panicking. You know, I said, well, can you tell me what it is over the phone? She said, you know, I need you to come in. Just in a few weeks, I need to go back to Nigeria and pray. So he said, I'm not going to let you take it as, you know, travel. You know, you have to take it as before you go to war. That is just a whole problem. And I don't want you to talk to me. I need to pray and see what God says before you take it out. He said, I'm not going to let you do that. So of course, the dog was, I kind of cried. You know, like my husband was, you know, really, really bad. Came back and said, you know, that was like 2 a.m. already. So he said, oh, hearing, you know, I get a preliminary, you know, result, and, just something looks abnormal. You know, it looks like some hair is playing better than what it is. Why? At least something is wrong the whole time, you know. So I said, well, what do you do? He said, well, get me a CD and, you know, give it to a doctor. So I took the CD and I said, I'm going to look at this to see what it is. And I said, you know what? Let me just leave it alone and sleep. So the next day I called my doctor. I went over, gave him the CD, said, you know, looked at the report. He said, so I said, well, what does that mean? He said, well, it looks complicated. So I said, okay. You know, I said, well, he's like, well, it can be this or it can be that. I mean, it just looked like something I've never seen before. I said, well, I don't think my life will be that complicated, you know? So he said, you know, I'll get a second opinion, I'll get a second person to, you know, read it and give me a report. So, you know, and then he gave me a appointment 1 month later. So they called me and said, we have a result coming. So I said, is it bad? He said, well, you know, the doctor will go over and review. So that was in March. I went in, you know, the doctor looked at it, he said, yeah, it just looks complicated. I mean, I haven't seen this before. I said, well, what is it? He said, well, you know, just, you know, and it was like one thing to the other, nothing, you know, specific. He said, you know, do I have cancer? He said, well, you know, I mean, not specific, but, you know, I mean, it can be dead, it can be done, or something's bad enough. So I said, well, you know what? At this point, whatever it is, you know, whatever it is. So he said, you know, the best thing for me to do is to do surgery, you know, because it's not conclusive at this point, whatever it is, they just look like normal. So they scheduled me for surgery last Wednesday. You know, when I went in there, I went to my prayer for Monday. They went through the whole procedure. I mean, he has like a whole bunch of procedures that he was going to perform. So, you know, the nurse was going over, you know, this, that. I said, well, this body, you know, like, he has to remove all this stuff. So I said, well, can I get a liposuction? You know, make sure everything is done, you know. So the nurse said, well, I just want to make sure you understand the procedure, you know, because he's going to be doing a hysterectomy. I said, for me? He said, I said, we never talked about that. You know, she said, well, you know, the doctor will go over it with you. So I said, all I know, I can make a laparoscopy surgery. That's it. You know, removing anything. She said, well, I just want to make sure you know what, you know, is going to happen. Yeah, so I, you know, started praying. I said, this is not what I'm doing here, right? If he found something else before I got there, he should have, you know, told me. You know, I said, I'm not going to bother the doctor. So I went in, you know, the doctor said, hi. I said, hi. You know, then I closed my eyes and started praying. You know, 5 minutes, fell asleep, woke up within an hour, he was done. I said, well, because the room was scheduled for 4 hours, so, you know, to remove everything. So within an hour, you know, he was back. And then within the next hour, I woke up and I looked at the clock, 9:30. I said, I'm coming at 7:40. He said, no, I'm already awake. So I started catching my stomach, looking, where did they come? I was like, yeah. I said, well, where did they remove the whole, you know, hysterectomy? So I said, yeah, they did come. So I just saw this, you know, little hole here. I said, oh. So I said, no, what did they do? He's like, wow, you're very nice. You know, he didn't remove anything. You know, he didn't, I said, you just told me that, you know, and he said, you're very lucky. You know, you're very lucky. It was just an infection. I said, well, he didn't remove anything. He said, you're very lucky. You know, you were right. You were right. I said, I told you not here for removing anybody. Yeah, so, you know, my husband came in and, you know, he said, wow, look, you want to look at the picture of your infant? I said, no. You know, no panic attack. He's like, yeah, look at the picture, you know. He didn't remove anything. He said, it's just an infection. He didn't give you prescription. I said, what? For a whole year, nothing was removed. So I'm standing here. My surgery is, I mean, I've got it. It's just a little poke there, that's it. So I'm just taking medication, that's it. So, I mean, it took a year that I learned a lot, you know, very close to God. I mean, a different person for that whole year. So I think it's good for me to have gone through it, been here, been more prayerful. I mean, everything about me is good. I am very glad.
that it wasn't a good thing to go through, but I think I did. I got the good, really got the good thing out of it. Fortunately, got it. So I grew more, I learned how to pray, I pray more, and I prayed to God all the time.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We say so happens to us. She came here, thank you. I remember that day when she said, Susan, what time I'm there? Everybody's going to tell me, Pastor, this is a thing, the thing of anxiety and the Lord used that situation to change her. She's the day she was God, and can you hear the testimony now of everything that she was thinking? The Lord told everything. It could have been worse, it could have been another thing. But the Lord told it, and through that process, she became a better person in Christ. Their prayer life, spirituality, she got brought back into her to change her. Let's give God all the praise, let's give God all the praise, and let's pray for her that this testimony that she has shared today, affliction will not arrive a second time in my life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Christian, you have You can testify your own God from glory to glory, from strength to strength, from power to power. In your spiritual life, you will never diminish. You will increase. You will expand. You will enlarge in the name of Jesus. You will become a blessing to many. You will become a repair of many broken walls. Through your many shall become broken. Through your many shall turn this way. Through your testimony, many lives have been transformed in the name of the Lord Jesus. Is there anyone back home watching us online that is thinking, Lord, when will you do my own thing? Lord, I pray the same grace that is in this house that came to the testimony of our sister. She came here and the Lord responded to her cry. She came here with a burden, and today she's testifying that God has done to the Lord. I pray for that woman and that man watching from home tonight or watching in this church, believing God for transformation. Jehovah, let this miracle repeat itself in the life of everyone, trusting God for something in the name of Jesus. Let it be a glorious end. Let it be a glorious end. Father, we thank you. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we give you worship. In Jesus' name, we are filled with you. Congratulations, man. Yes. Let's give our offering to the Lord as we give you. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. God is good. Thank you, Lord. We are very, very grateful for all you have done for us. But Lord, we are very, very grateful. We are saved. Thank you, Jesus. Very, very grateful for all you have done for us. Oh, God, we are very, very grateful.
Lord, we ask that you perfect that which you already started in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for everyone that is here with us. And we pray as we have come again tonight, we ask that you grant the desires of every heart in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your word tonight, O God, and we receive grace today, even as we have come, O Lord, that we will do your word, O God, in the name of Jesus. We will not only be hearers of your word, but we will be doers of your word. We ask for grace and strength, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, to continue in this walk with you, O God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Thank you for tonight's offering, O God. As we have given, O Lord, in obedience to your word, we ask, O Lord, that you honor your word in the life of every giver tonight, in the name of Jesus. As many, O Lord, tonight that are willing, but are not able to be, Father, we ask that you provide for them in the name of Jesus, for every tiger in this open the windows of heaven in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We say, blessed be your name, O God. As you go tonight, we ask that you go before and ask for help from you. Thank you for your Christ Jesus in the name of Jesus. As we continue in this week, O God, as always, Lord, we depend on you, O God. We ask that you take us here and have faith in the name of Jesus. Lord, we declare that we have favor before you and before every man. Father, we thank you. Be thou with us, O God. Thank you for the rest of the services this week. Thank you for the services tomorrow. We ask that your glory fill this place in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you as you continue to do what you alone can do in this house. And we say, blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have faith. Shall we share the grace of fellowship? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. The love of God. And the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. And you prophesy into your life tonight that surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. I'll tell how tomorrow at 12 we have the Sabbath prayer for 7 p.m. Sabbath on Sunday is 7:30 for the men. Yeah. 9:30 a.m. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Before we go, please, I'm going to announce this. I'm going to close our keys. In the house, please, let's. This place, if you come up here, there are a lot of stuff here that. The people that are going to stand and walk, they put their love for what's here. So please, make sure the keys, please, we don't want the keys to fall in your hand, please. We love out here. So please, watch the father from Sunday, he left me from little kids, he left me coming down here. Please, let's watch your adults, please. Let's watch your little be blocking some of those things so that they please watch the kids so that they will not swim themselves. Praise the Lord. So, Sunday, 7:30, 9:30, 7:30.